Two elderly women's bucket list items have police knocking on their doors. Think of some activities you would like to do before you are too old. Skydiving might come to mind, or maybe getting scuba certified and diving the Great Barrier Reef. But for Josie Birds and In Broken Brow, their bucket lists contain something else altogether. At 93 and 104 years old, respectively, Josie and In have lived very long and fulfilling lives. But there is one thing they've always wanted to do. Trust us when we say it's not what you think. Josie Birds was a 93-year-old grandmother, living a quiet life in Manchester. So, imagine her surprise when she opened her front door to see two police officers standing on her front porch. They were there to arrest her. Now, Josie hadn't done anything wrong. But on top of the bit of anxiety that comes with police officers showing at your house to arrest you, the elderly woman was also a bit excited. But the drop-by wasn't spontaneous. Josie's daughter, Pam, actually contacted the local police station a few days before they showed up at the house. But, unlike most daughters with an elderly mother, Pam wasn't asking the department to check up on her mother. Actually, it was just the opposite. Pam asked the local authorities to go to her mother's house and slap handcuffs on her wrists. Why would Pam ask them to do such a thing? Josie invited the cops inside. She never expected what happened next, can you? A few days after Pam made the phone call, two Manchester police officers arrived at Josie's front door. After ringing the doorbell, it took a few minutes for the elderly woman to make it to the door. Once she opened the door and noticed who was standing there, Josie invited the two officers inside, not expecting they were there to arrest her. We mean, what could the 93-year-old possibly have done to have her daughter call the cops? By now, we'd imagine you have quite a funny image in your head of this old lady being escorted out of her house in handcuffs, flanked by two officers. Well, we're here to tell you that it was a bit more civil and less forceful than anything you've seen in the movies. That means there was no struggle, yelling, or conflict of any kind. Josie actually went with the two officers pretty willingly. Instead of the typical police theatrics, these two gently clasped Josie's wrists in handcuffs. Then, in her front hallway, they read the elderly lady her rights. Of course, the two officers were having the hardest time keeping straight faces. After all, Josie technically didn't do anything. This whole scheme was set up by her daughter, Pam, who was having a great time watching the arrest. But why did she send the officers to her mother's house? After cuffing Josie and reading her rights aloud, the two officers escorted her out to their car. If you didn't guess it, this was Josie's first time riding in the back of a police car. And now here she was, being driven down to the town precinct to be charged and booked. The only thing was, she had no clue what she was being charged with. They didn't say anything while reading her rights. Now, she was just along for the ride. Once the two officers made it to their station, they went through all of the appropriate steps to book Josie. They sat the grandmother down on a seat while they filled out all of the paperwork. Then, something amazing happened. The officers took Josie to a cell, sat her down on the uncomfortable bed, and slammed the bars closed behind them. Josie was officially in the books as being arrested by the Manchester police. Ironically, Josie wasn't scared about being arrested or sitting in a jail cell. It was exactly the opposite, actually. The grandmother was thrilled about the entire ordeal, smiling the entire time she was being processed. As it turned out, Josie had written about her arrest years before Pam called the local police station. If you can believe it, the 93-year-old lady wanted to get arrested. And her daughter was the one to make her dream a reality. Josie had written something years before that included getting arrested. Can you guess what she wrote? Years before, Josie had written out a bucket list. One of the items on the list was, in fact, getting arrested. With the help of Pam, Josie was finally able to check the item off her list. After getting wind of why Josie was sitting in a cell, an officer even went to speak with the elderly woman before releasing her. Interestingly, she wasn't the first arrest the officer had heard about. And Broken Brow is 104 years old and living in a senior home in Stoke Bishop, Bristol. Being in a home offered a lot of perks, including various activities the residents were allowed to participate in. But there was one activity, in particular, and was excited about, and it wasn't bingo night. On the contrary, the activity, and was interested in would have one of her longtime dreams come true. It was just a matter of the home allowing her bizarre request. One of the activities the residents of the senior home are allowed to participate in is the Bristol Wishing Washing Line. It is a huge board set up in the community room, asking residents to fill out a form illustrating a wish they would like to have granted. The activity was part of a charity the home was supporting, but Anne saw it as her chance to make her bizarre wish. Now, she just had to wait and see if it was going to be granted. Anne's wish was to shed her good girl persona. Can you guess what she asked for? The answer is coming up next. The older woman had never committed a crime in her long life, so her wish was to get arrested. Never being on the wrong side of the law in her 104 years, and was ready to get into some trouble. Even if that trouble was technically fictional, the elderly woman was ready to have her wrists cuffed and to be booked in the local police station. Of course, with such an odd request, the Bristol police had no choice but to answer. The senior home workers got together to make Anne's wish come true. Their first step was contacting the Bristol Police Department. They were totally on board with making Anne's wish come true, sending a few officers over to the home. After seeing a few uniformed officers walking towards the otherwise quiet home, Anne knew her wish had been granted. She could barely contain her excitement as the three cops walked over to her. The officers tried to keep the smiles off their faces, but it was hard when Anne was so excited about being arrested for the first time in her long life. Due to her age, the officers took great care of clasping the cuffs around her wrists. Of course, Anne really didn't care what they did. She was just happy her wish was being granted, and she was able to experience getting arrested, said no one ever. Anne couldn't believe this was actually happening. Her entire life, Anne played by the rules, never taking risks that could land her in trouble with the law. But after 104 years, a little rule breaking is just what the doctor ordered. Everyone at the senior home couldn't help but smile as the officers and workers at the facility helped a cuffed and out of her chair and down the driveway. It was time to go to the station. It was time for Anne to make her first appearance as a wanted person at the police station. After the police officers placed handcuffs on Anne's wrists, they read her rights. After, it was time to get the 104-year-old outside to the waiting police car. Escorted by a few of the senior home workers, as well as the officers, Anne couldn't help but smile as they helped her into the car. She was finally living her dream of being a bad girl, getting arrested and throwing her status as a good girl out the window. Anne was getting the presidential treatment when it comes to arrests. The elderly woman was able to sit in the front seat instead of the back. Well, we suppose some special treatment was given, considering this wasn't an actual arrest, but a wish. So, all set in the front seat of the cop car, Anne was ready to head down to the station to be booked. Maybe they would even let her sit in one of the jail cells. After making sure Anne was safe and comfortable in the front seat, the officer driving took off towards the station to book the elderly woman. We're kind of curious what they booked her for. Maybe for being the coolest older lady in existence for wanting this last wish. Regardless, they finally made it to the station where Anne was booked. And while everyone tried to make the experience as authentic as possible, no one could help but smile. The arresting officers and senior home workers were so happy they were able to work together to pull off making Anne's wish come true. After all, it was probably one of the most out there wish requests the home received, so they kind of had to make it happen. Even so, Anne is most likely the oldest person the Bristol police had arrested in, well, ever. Anne can add that to her list of accomplishments she most likely has after 104 years of life. For Josie and Anne, their time in jail was just what they wanted in their old age. After living life by the book and not taking risks that would land them in trouble with the law, getting arrested was their much-needed rebellion. We should all take a page out of these two ladies' books and create a bucket list. Of course, if you add getting arrested, maybe wait until you are Josie and Anne's age to check off the item.